I said to my wife, we've been everywhere once and some places twice. As I had another helping of country ham, she said, we ain't never been to Vietnam. There's a bunch of our boys over there. So we went to the Orient, Saigon. Well, we got a big welcome when we drove in to the gates of a place that they call Long Ben. We checked in and everything got kind of quiet, but a soldier boy said, just wait till tonight, things get noisy. Things start happening. Big, bad firecracker. Well, that night we did about four shows for the boys, and they were living it up with a whole lot of noise. We did our last song for the night, and we crawled into bed for some peace and quiet, but things weren't peaceful. Things weren't quiet. Things were scary. Well, for a few minutes, June never said one word, and I thought at first that she hadn't heard. Then a shell exploded not 2 miles away. She sat up in bed, and I heard her say, what was that? I said, that was a shell or a bomb. She said, I'm scared. I said, me too. Well, all night long, that noise kept on, and the sound would chill you right to the bone. The bullets and the bombs and the mortar shells shook our bed every time one fell, and it never let up. It was gonna get worse before it got any better. Well, when the sun came up, the noise died down. We got a few minutes sleep, and we were sleeping sound. Then a soldier knocked on our door and said, the last night they brought in 7 dead and 14 wounded. And would we come down to the base hospital and see the boys? Yeah. So we went to the hospital ward by day, and every night we were singing away. Then the shells and the bombs till dawn again, and the helicopters brought in a wounded man. Night after night, day after day, coming and going. So we sadly sang for them our last song, and reluctantly we said so long. We did our best to let them know that we care for every last one of them that's over there, whether we belong over there or not. Somebody over here loves them and needs them. Well, that's about all that there is to tell about that little trip into living hell. And if I ever go back over there anymore, hope there's none of our boys there for me to sing for. I hope that war is over with and they all come back home to stay.